Hello students, welcome to my class of electromagnetic theory. In the last class, we discussed about the concept of bound charge and bound current. And today, we want to use the concept of bound charge and bound current to write down the Maxwell's equation in any matter or material. So when we talked about any material, it can be subject to both electric and magnetic polarization. Now you know that inside polarized matter, there are accumulation of bound charge and bound current. So to write down the Maxwell's equation in any material, one need to consider all the charges and currents, including free charge and free current. But interesting fact is that one does not have direct control on those bound charge and current, because they are controlled by external electric field and magnetic field. Thus, it would be very easy for anyone to write down the Maxwell's equation if we consider any explicit parameter, right? So on those explicit parameter, we have direct control, and that parameter is free charge and free current. So today actually we want to do that. Okay, so let's see. So what will be the total charge in any material? So total charge density, total charge density, we can write rho equal to rho F and rho B. What is rho F? Rho F is the charge density due to free charge present in the material, and rho B is the bound charge density due to the bound charge of the material. Now you know from the last class what is the bound charge. Bound charge is minus del dot P, divergence P vector, divergence of polarization vector, and you write the rho F. So total charge, if I write rho T, that will be like this. Now let's see what is the total current density. Okay, so total current density, total current density, if we write J, so JT, that will be JF, the current density due to the free current present in the material. Then for bound current, JB. Then another current we have to consider, that is JP. I am going to discuss this after 1 minute. So let's write it like this. JF, what is JB? We saw in the last class, that is curl M. So curl M. Now this form you can write del P, del P. So let's see how it is coming, del P, del P. Okay. So when we talked about any dielectric material and we place any electric field, then you know charges are separated and polarization will be generated in the material, and due to that polarization we can tell that some surface charge, bound charge, that is sigma B, and here this is minus sign, minus charge, so that will be generated, and direction of the polarization vector will be along the right direction. And suppose this tube of dielectric material and the area is suppose D and A perpendicular. Okay, now what will be the current? Now how the current is generated? Suppose the polarization vector or polarization is changing with time, it changes, suppose it increases little bit, then if it is increases, then this charge density will also increase. So the positive charge, actually what will happen, if P increases, it will move further in this right direction, and the negative charge will move in the left direction, because they will be separated, and more magnetic, more electric dipole moment, or then polarization will be, electric polarization will be generated. So they will be separated. Okay. So if it is changes with time, the change will come in this change of charge density also. So we can write it like this: del rho, del sigma B del T, then dA perpendicular, right? Then we can write sigma B is actually P, we saw in the last class, If it is a perpendicular, the direction of E vector and the normal of this surface is along the same direction, then sigma b equal to p, then we can write this is like this. So this is actually the polarization current of any dielectric material when the polarization is increases. Okay, so that we have to include here. Now, so we have considered all the currents present in the material. Now, what is the Gauss's law? So let's formulate the Maxwell's equation. What is the Gauss's law? Gauss's law is del dot E, then rho total by epsilon naught, rho total by epsilon naught, and rho total is what? Rho F plus rho B, right? Okay, so rho B we know minus del dot B. So here I can write this is rho F, that is for free charge, minus del dot P by epsilon naught, right? Now we let's multiply it like this. So rho F minus del dot P, right? So here if we keep it at the left side, then it will be epsilon naught E plus P equal to rho F, right? So here what is this? This is called, so epsilon naught E plus P is called the D. What is D? D is called displacement vector. Displacement vector. So inside any dielectric material, due to the applied external electric field, inside the material electric field, resultant electric field or total electric field will change, right? So as a result, the displacement vector will change and displacement vector comes into the picture. So as a whole, we have to consider the displacement vector when we consider about dielectric material. Okay, so let's write down the Maxwell's equation now, considering the polarization and free charge. So we reach at this point epsilon naught E plus P, that is rho F, right? So here we can write this. So this is now the new Maxwell's equation we can write in presence of any material. Now let's write down the next equation, that is, so next or second Maxwell's equation is divergence B equal to 0. So that remains same, that remains same. Okay, now come to the third Maxwell equation. Come to the third Maxwell equation, and that is, we know curl E equal to, okay, now here this is also remain same, this is also remain same. Okay, now come to the fourth Maxwell equation, that is modified Ampere's circuital law. So this form remains same, that is, and the fourth Maxwell equation, that is curl B equal to mu 0 J total, right, plus mu 0 epsilon naught del E del E, right? Okay, now let's write down the mu 0 J here, mu 0 J T form. Okay, mu 0 in place of J T we have to write J free, J bound, and J P, and mu 0 epsilon naught del E del T, right? Now you write down mu 0 J F in place of J B curl M, and in place of J P del P del T, and here mu 0 del E del T, right? So now what we will do, here is also curl B, here is also card M. So we will keep these card terms in the same side. So let's do that. I am rubbing it. So card into B, right? So if we keep it mu 0 m, right, then in right side mu 0 jf, and here this is mu 0 del p del t plus mu 0 epsilon 0 del e del t, right? Okay, so let's combine these two. I am rubbing this. Let's combine these two. If we combine this, this will be card B mu 0 m, okay, then mu 0 jf, then mu 0. So this is a vector. Current density is a vector quantity, so we have to put the vector sign, and here it will be mu 0 if you take common, then okay. So again we have to time derivative part we can take out, so epsilon 0 e plus p, right? So this is what, this is d, so from here we can write jf mu 0 del d del t, right, del d del t, okay. Now let's divide it by mu 0 term both side. So if we divide it, and here we can take it inside this card term, and it becomes like this, okay. Then this is jf, this is jf, this is jf, and this is del d del t, this is del d del t, this is del d del t, right? Now what is this? Here we can tell this is H. What is H? H is called the magnetic field intensity. And what is this B? B is called magnetic flux density, and B is called magnetic flux density. And what is this M? M is the magnetization. So actually what happens, you are applying magnetic field, which is H, in the magnetic material that we discussed, the paramagnetic material or ferromagnetic material or diamagnetic material, you are applying a magnetic field. Now depending upon the magnetization, the magnetic flux will change inside the material. So that's it, that's what is happening here. So let's write it here again. So the fourth Maxwell's equation, the form becomes curl H equal to jf plus del d del t. So this is the form of fourth Maxwell equation in place of any material, okay. Now, okay, here one term, yeah, so this is like that. Okay, so let's write down the Maxwell's equation again. First Maxwell equation is del dot d, that is rho f, right? Then del dot b, del dot b equal to 0. Then curl e equal to minus del b del t. So this is the first equation, this is the second, this is the third and this is the fourth equation, right? Now here if you see these forms of Maxwell's equation are combination of E, B, then E and B, B and H. Now let's see what is the relation between these parameters, how they are connected, because they are not different. E and B is not different. How they are connected, that we you can see and you can modify these accordingly. So let's see what is the relation between E and D, okay, and B and H. So we know what is polarization. Polarization is P, and how they are related with electric field. If you apply electric field or increase electric field, polarization will increase, and they are related like this. So this is the permittivity in free space. This is the susceptibility, electrical susceptibility of any dielectric material, and this is the applied electric field. Now you know that D is epsilon 0 E plus P. Now let's put it here. So this will be epsilon 0 E plus epsilon 0 pi E T, right? So if you take common epsilon 0, then 1 plus chi E, right? So here it becomes, so the here you can tell this is actually epsilon. So T equal to epsilon. So this epsilon is permittivity of that dielectric material, and that this is related like this with the free space permittivity. Okay, now let's see the magnetization, the relation between the magnetic field and magnetic flux density. So again we can tell this magnetization M is chi M, that is related to magnetization, so susceptibility, magnetic susceptibility, and this is H, right? And we know B equal to, so B by mu 0 minus M is actually H. So let's multiply B equal to here mu 0, and let's keep it to the right side, then mu 0 H, then mu 0 M, right? And you put the form of M here, so this is like this, then it becomes mu 0 chi M H. Let's take mu 0 H common, so 1 plus chi M plus into H. So here mu 0 1 plus chi M is actually called mu, okay? So B becomes mu H. So inside the material, the magnetic field and magnetic flux is related like this. So if we want to write down the Maxwell's equation in all the same parameters we want to use, means E and B or D and H, so we have to modify the Maxwell's equation using these forms. Okay, so this is all about them, how to write down the Maxwell's equation in any matter. Now next I want to discuss a small conceptual part, that is the magnetic charge. What is magnetic charge? What is magnetic charge? So electric charge, you know that plus Q or minus Q, and magnetic charge, if we talk about, that means we are talking about magnetic monopoles. Magnetic monopoles means we are considering individual north pole or south pole. Now till now we have discussed that north pole and south pole does not exist separately. They always present in the same bar magnet or same material. They are interrelated. That's why the magnetic field is always in close line. But suppose they are separated. Actually, Dirac uses this concept to prove that the electric charge is quantized. So that is theoretical aspect, and we don't want to discuss all those things because of our syllabus is beyond that. So we cannot discuss all those detailed theory here. But only that that in the theoretical aspect, people use the concept of magnetic monopole or magnetic charge. Okay. But in real existence, means experimentally, till now there is no proof of magnetic monopole. But let's discuss in theoretical way. Suppose we don't know the Maxwell's equation, how Maxwell equation is formed, means the electrostatic Gauss's law, Mendelssohn's Gauss's law, Faraday's induction law, Ampere's law. We don't know. We are giving you four Maxwell's equations. Suppose. And first, we are giving you those four Maxwell's equations, means del dot E, that is rho E by epsilon naught. This is the electrical charge density. Then divergence B. Now, here it is zero because we know that magnetic monopole does not exist. But suppose magnetic monopole exists, so how we will write it? We will write it as mu 0 J, mu 0 rho M, mu 0 rho M. So rho m is the magnetic charge. So okay, then curl B equal to curl E, third law is curl E, that is minus del B del T. Okay, minus del B del T, and with 8 we have to consider the current due to the magnetic charge, right? Mu 0 Jm, and why it is minus sign? Because you know that this change in magnetic flux or magnetic current will oppose the EMF. EMF will be generated in such a way that it will oppose these changes, right? So that's why there is minus sign. And curl B equal to that mu 0 J E, right? Mu 0 J E plus mu 0 epsilon 0 del E del T. So this is the first equation, this is the second equation, this is the third Maxwell's equation here, and this is the fourth Maxwell's equation. Now if we take divergence of third equation, suppose let's write the divergence of third equation. If we take divergence on this third equation, it becomes like this. So in the right side, this is del del T divergence B, and then mu 0 divergence Jm. Okay, so left side is always 0, left side is always 0. So here we can write del del T and divergence B. Using the second Maxwell's equation here, we can write, what is that? Mu 0 rho m, mu 0 rho m, and then here it will be minus mu 0 divergence j m, right, equal to 0. Okay, so we can write here that del dot jm equal to what? Minus, so if you take it that side, it will be del rho m del t, right? So this is the continuity equation of current due to the magnetic charge, right? So continuity equation is the conservation of charge, right? Continuity equation comes from conservation of charge. So here also, if we consider magnetic charge, continuity equation should valid. Now similarly, if we use the divergence in fourth equation like this, so here it will be divergence mu 0. So let's write here. So divergence mu 0 j e, right, plus mu 0 epsilon naught del del t divergence e. Now divergence divergence e rho e by epsilon naught, and so here it is mu 0 del j e, it is 0, and this is mu 0 rho e, right? So from here, so del del t we have to write. So from here also we are getting the continuity equation of the current due to the electric charge. So del rho del t. So this is the continuity equation for electric charge, right? Now up to this is our discussion of magnetic charge. We will not go beyond this. So here we can do one small assignment using the concept of magnetic charge. Now you write down the assignment here, that so you know what is Coulomb's law in electrostatic case. So whenever there are two charge, they will feel some force. Now if in this case there are two magnetic charge, so they will feel some force. So the force horn, we can write mu 0 by 4 pi. So write down the assignment, mu 0 by 4 pi, then q m 1 q m 2 if I write the charge for one magnetic charge m 1, and this is charge for another magnetic charge, then this is r square, then r cap. Okay, so if so this is the force between two magnetic charge. Now the question is, we have to find out the force law, that is the Lorentz force for monopole. So you have to find out the Lorentz force for monopole. So this assignment I will give you, so you try it. Okay, so in terms of the electric field, in terms of electric field and magnetic field, that you have to find out. Okay, so thank you.